pick a magic number and see yourself in 10 years. This is a little tricky. Which one should I pick? Should I pick 4, 56, 29? I will probably go with the last one, 29. Oh my god, it was too good to be true. Alright, at this point, if you didn't guess it, I'm going to be showing you how to create images and put them inside of your Roblox game as part of our GUI tutorial guide. But not only display images, but we can also display images that we can click on to have another level of interaction from the player as well. So those are the two things I'm going to be showing you how to do in this episode, so let's jump straight into it. Alright, let's think about this for a minute. Now, obviously, we can't add these images if we don't know where to get these images in the first place. So one of the most popular places to look for them is in the game's toolbox. And if you don't know where the toolbox is, we pretty much just go up here to view. And then there should be this little button here that says toolbox. I'm pretty sure it's also located in the homepage. Right here in the insert category. So if we click on this, then on the left side or wherever it's going to appear on your screen should be the game's toolbox that have all of these user-generated content that you can place inside of your Roblox game. To look for images specifically, we will click on this dropdown that says models, and we're going to click on images, and now we have this whole library of images to use for our Roblox game. I wanted to point this out just in case you were not familiar with the toolbox, so with that being said, now we have all these images to work with to add to our Roblox game, but now it comes down to what type of object are we going to use to actually insert these images inside of our game? And one of them that I'm going to be showing you right now are called image labels. And these are essentially instances made by Roblox to be able to display these images inside of a Roblox game without doing anything too special. All we can really do is just display them, and that's pretty much about it. So how we're going to do that is we're going to go to the right side of our screen with the Explorer, and then we're going to hit the plus sign next to Starter GUI, and of course we're going to create a screen GUI because we can't add any GUI elements unless we have a screen GUI to put into. So then we're going to hit the plus sign, and then we're now going to insert an image label. So let's click on this, and as you can see, on the top left side of the screen, an image with this little placeholder image icon looking thing over here is now displayed on our screen. So we can drag this around, we can scale it up and down as we want to. And now we have our image, but now it just comes down to displaying the right image that we pick out from this catalog. So let's say we wanted to pick an image from this image category. Wow, all of these are like actually really bad. So let's say we had this Deadly Dark Dominus right here. If we wanted to display this in our image label, we need to understand how image URLs work, but I'm going to be showing you that once we script it. But for right now, we're just going to hard-codely put it into the game. So as you know, all these images, they have their own unique ID or identification numbers to differentiate one image from another one. It's how we're able to know this is the image we're looking for is we're going to need to get the ID of the image. And the way we're going to do that is by right-clicking on the image and then clicking this button that says Copy Asset ID. So we're going to click this. And then what we're going to do is we're going to select our image label on the Explorer. And then we're going to scroll down just a little bit until we find this property called image. So if we click on this image, it's basically a string that contains a directory to the placeholder image that Roblox already has for us. So we're gonna delete this, and as you can see now, the image basically shows nothing, not even the placeholder image, because we want to now replace this with our new image that we just copied. So let's highlight our image, let's right-click and then paste our new ID, and then let's hit enter. Okay, so now we have our image that we were looking for, but you might notice that we copied the image ID and we pasted it into here, and it was just these numbers, but Roblox automatically added this little URL pretext before our number. So what does all this mean? So essentially what RBX asset ID is that this is the location stored in Roblox's servers that stores all of these newly generated assets. And all you need to do to retrieve these assets is by specifying the ID of that asset and bringing it into your Roblox game. So and this is really important when we're scripting, because if we, let's say, scripted this image, so let's add a local script inside of our screen GUI, and let's make reference to our image label by saying local image equals script.parent.imageLabel. Let's say we want to change the image inside of our script. So let's say image.image, because that's the property that we're trying to change here, equals, and then if we, let's say, just had these numbers here. This would not work because image is a string, and so you might think, okay, well, why don't I just do this? This doesn't really work either because it doesn't count as a valid image address. So I just joined into the game, and as you can see, the image is not loaded. And when I went to my player to see the image label change, the image, all it is now is just a bunch of numbers. It's not a URL address to the right asset image that we're trying to retrieve. So that's why it's very important to memorize this RBX asset ID pretext to add it alongside to your image ID. So once again, the way we do this is we go to our script, and then right before our numbers, we're going to say RBX asset ID with two S's, colon, forward slash, and then our numbers, and then our asset ID right after that. I think it's very beneficial to memorize this URL address, so if you have the time when you're going through adding images to your Roblox game, I would keep in mind to memorize this address pretext right before your image ID, because it'll save you a lot of time in the long run, especially when you know how to add images into your game a lot faster rather than having to just look it up. So that is basically how you change the image property inside of your Roblox game. All right, and there are some other properties that make image labels unique to other GUI elements. The first one is just being image transparency, but this is specifically for the image. So it's important to know the difference between image transparency versus background transparency, because background transparency is for like the little border that's behind the image, but image transparency is the transparency of the image itself. So key difference to point out there. And then we also have image color 3, which is basically the same thing, where it's like we can change the color of the image specifically to a more tint color. Now, this is by default, the image color is white. So whenever we change the color, it just makes the colors of the image whatever it already is, but adds a little tint to it. So it doesn't completely change the color of the image. It's more like it adds a tint to it. So that's something I wanted to emphasize there as well. All right, so now we've been able to successfully add our images to the game, but Roblox has another GUI element that adds more user interactivity to our images, and that's called an image button. And I think that's pretty self-explanatory what an image button is. It's basically what you're looking at right here as the image label, but the player is able to click on it and make the script that's contained in it to do what it needs to do when the player clicks on the image button. So I'm gonna show you what that looks like inside of our same script. So let's go back to our local script. And then down here, let's drop two lines. Let's first of all create a new image button, actually, now that I think about it. So let's go to our game and let's click on the plus sign next to screen GUI and let's insert an image button. And this is pretty much what it's gonna look like. It's gonna look exactly like the image label in terms of how it has a placeholder image right before it. So let's go to our catalog and try to look for another image we can possibly use. Let's go for this Bloxel Lantern OC, whatever this is. Let's copy it and let's go to our image button's image property and let's just paste that in. And then now we have an image for it, and you can see that we can hover over this image as well, and it'll change the color of the background color to a slightly darker color. So this is how you know that this is an image button. But now let's get to scripting it. So inside of our script, let's make reference to our image button. So we're gonna say local button equals script.parent.imageButton. All right, and so now what we'll do is we're gonna say button.mouseButton1click colon connect function open and close parentheses enter. So you kind of understand how this works already. So this is how we're going to detect the click from the player. It's using this mouse button one click event, and we can pretty much just print something random to let us know that the button has been clicked. So we're going to say button has been clicked And then there we go. That's pretty much all you need to know to detect the user click whenever we play the game. So let's go hit test and hit play so that we can see the results of our image button. All right, so I'm in the game. Let's press the button. And as you can see on the output, it says button has been clicked. And we can click this as many times as we want because the script is basically detecting every single time a user clicks on this button and it's going to print button has been clicked on the output. So this is pretty much working as intended. And now there's two more properties that are unique to image buttons. And that's when you can change the image of the image button whenever you hover over the image and also when you press the image. So these are two separate properties with different images that you can put if you decide to do so. So we can have one for when we hover over the image with this hover image property and one when we press it with this pressed image property down here. So if we go to our toolbox and we try to look for an image, let's take this Dominus Azure light right here. Let's right click it and hit copy asset ID. And then let's select our hover image and let's paste it and hit enter. And then let's pick another image for when we press the button. So we can probably pick, let's say this haunted Valkyrie helm right here. So let's right click it, copy asset ID, go over to pressed image and then hit paste, enter. And now what will happen is if we hover over the image, then it should change to the Dominus Azure light, as you can see right here. When I unhover it, then you will not see the Dominus Azure light anymore, and it'll go back to our regular image. So then I'll hover over this, and now let's press it. So if I hold down the press button, then it's going to change the image to the haunted Valkyrie helm. And if I let go, then it's just going to go back to our hover image, which is the Dominus Azure light, and then we unhover, it's going to go back to our normal image. And so that's pretty much it for that. There are other properties like image rect offset and image rect size and also the scale types, but these are a little complicated and I'm not going to go over them in this episode, but in a later episode further down the line in this GUI tutorial guide, I will go over scale types in its own separate video because there's a lot to take in for this concept. So this is pretty much where I'm going to leave it at for this episode. This served as an introductory to image buttons and image labels, and I hope you found this video to be informative. If you want to learn another GUI element that I've made a video on up until this point so far, then I encourage you to watch my text box video that I made as part of my GUI tutorial guide, or you could just watch everything I have with this GUI tutorial guide up until this point and follow along through the journey as I uncover more GUI related concepts into this guide. So I hope you're gonna stick around for that. And that's pretty much gonna be it for this episode. I hope you found this video to be helpful and I will see you in the next one. Take care.